Hello everybody, Music Man here, and welcome to part 2 of our sneak peek of ACW 3.6. Thank you so much for joining me today. I have a lot of stuff to share with you, a lot of things that are happening, and so let's just kind of really get into it because it is going to take a while. I don't want to have a huge long video here because, you know, I want you to enjoy a nice lengthy video. So let's go ahead and I just wanted to show you this. I do want to kind of go into a little bit more deeper on what we were talking about in the last part. So I'm just going to do I don't think this is too much tall grass here. We'll find out though. But anyway, one thing I wanted to mention that is now in this mod is that when you go to theater, you have Western Theater and Eastern Theater. Now, I think the last part, if you want to go back and watch it, I think it by default, it goes to the Western Theater, and that was the units that we had available. So if you want to go to the Eastern Theater, there's a whole spiel of units, other units that are available that wasn't available in the Western Theater. So I'm going to go ahead and do the Eastern Theater for you. And first of all, I want to show you, I just have a lot of stuff that I was going to show you guys today. So let's, what I want to do is, let's see. I'm gonna get all these generals together and show you these generals. We got Stuart, Pickett, Lee, Mosby, Johnston. We have Beauregard, Longstreet, Forrest, Claiborne, and Bragg, and Hood. Those are the ones that I want to look at today with the Confederates. Don't worry, we will switch over to the Union, and we will see those as well. And also, there's some other things that I wanted to mention that we didn't quite figure out the last part that now I have a grasp of. So, and as you can see on the Eastern Theater, you have some different things that are available here. So first, let's see. What do I want? Let's get the Virginia Infantry, 11th Georgia Infantry, Charleston Zouaves. I love Richmond Zouaves. Let's get those. Pelican Regiment. We've already seen the Engineers, we've seen the Slavic Volunteers, Mounted Cav, we've seen those, ooh, Citadel Cadets, they look really cool. We got the Virginia Military Institute Cadets, I'd like to see those. If you notice in Gods and Generals, the Virginia Institute, that's where most of them came. So I think that'll be good. We'll be able to see these in action. But I just want to show you this real quick. So we'll get on the battle, and I'm just going to have some just random stuff here. I'm not going to go into the Union just right yet, but we're going to focus on the CSA right now. So we'll see you on the battle map. Okay, looks like we've gotten everything set up here. I just quickly just want to show you, kind of dive a little deeper into what we were talking about last part. So let's kind of look at our Richmond Zouaves here. Oh, they look cool. These are, I believe, they're skirmishers. Now, we can see here that these guys are C1. Now, what this means is that your C1, all your C1s are going to be your finest rifled muskets, usually with your sharpshooters, and pretty much your newer models. See the Richmond 1862. At this time, it is a newer model. So this is what the C1 is. It is the better class, the newer models, the finest rifles with your muskets and your sharpshooters that they have. So that's C1. Now, as you can see with the green here on the cone, you see that the green right over here kind of turns into a little yellow. Okay, now what this means is that if you kind of look at the cone here on the range, so you can see that the top little part of this, so that'd be about right there, the top part of that, that means they're going to hit the enemy a little less from that distance. So be right here. They're not going to be as effective. So that means when you want to get them a little closer to about right here, so that they can be able to hit the enemy effectively. That's what this means. Now we can go to, here is your C2 with your Military Institute Cadets. You can see them right there. They're using the Lorenz rifle. Now this is a 1839. They were founded. So Lorenz rifle, the C2 means that they're the older models, the shorter barrel guns, such as your shotguns and your pistols, and also with your rifles. So as you can see, the comb here, the green is about halfway. and then you got yellow up in here, and then you got red. Now what that means is that if you are facing the enemy and their range, they're entered into about right here, you're not going to hit much because it's in the red. They don't have as good as accuracy at that particular range. And you go down here to the yellow, they hit a little bit more, but really on this unit you're going to really want to get them up close and personal to about right up in here to really for them to be as effective as can be. So now let's see if we can get a, let's see if we can find us a C3, which I don't think we have. There we go. On the generals. Oh, hello ESPN, how are you? Turn you down. Now the C3 here on Braxton Bragg. Now the C3 means that these are the outdated smoothbore muskets. Your shorter barreled weapons. Now this means that when you get your, let's go over Braxton Bragg. Let's go over to him real quick. Yeah. So that means that you, when they fire, and some infantry also has C3 as well, so what you're going to have to do is you're really going to have to get them about right here to really fire and actually do any damage. So if you get them out to here, they're not going to hit much. That is what your that's what the C is. That is your class of your guns that is being added into this mod. Now let's go a little deeper and critical think about this. Let's do some critical thinking. How does this play a part? Well, this really adds a different style to how you're going to adapt your strategy into your battles. Because let's just say we have, let's just say with these Zouaves, they're a C1. Okay, so we get the Zouaves there. They're a C1. If you had a C1 pitted up against the C3, obviously it's not going to go well for the C3. Because the C3s, they're more outdated and they're not as effective. Whereas the C1, they can actually hit the enemy way out here. So that's, you're going to have to remember that when you do your battles and adapt your strategy, is because this is what has been added into this mod to give it a different dynamic, and it really, really changes the way that you're going to be fighting your enemy. So the C1 here with the comb, and you got C2, C3. Now this, all the classes and everything, this is meant to represent the type of technology and increasing technology and increasing weaponry that came about in the Civil War. And this is how you should adapt your strategy. So maybe with me personally, you can have your C1s, they will do the most damage. And maybe you can have your C3s, because you're going to have to get your C2s and C3s closer to the enemy for them to actually do any damage. So you can have them on the flank, they can come in, or you can have the C1s fire, and then you can do like a sneaky move to, you know, to stop them firing, and then rush up with the C2 and C3s and have them fire. So, you know, it creates, you know, there's different strategies that you could use with this, and that's how this dynamic is added. It changes the way that you're going to play your battles. So I think that is very, very, very cool. And so that's kind of what that is. So as far as classes, so we can go here. I think all these are, so we got a C2 with the Institute Cadets, C2 with the South Carolina Battalion of State Cadets, which actually I'd like to see those. Something's wrong with my keyboard today. It's not wanting to work. Need to get a new keyboard. You can see these guys, they are using the where you at? Charleston Zouaves. Yeah, that's them. Where was that at? Where was that at? Citadel Cadets. They are the C2 using the Lorenz rifle. The Zouaves are using the Charleston. I think is it the Enfield P1853. So the 53, they are a newer model, so they're going to be a lot more effective, and they're going to be able to hit out really here in this range because it's a C1. So that's really how these classes are working, guys, and this is how it's going to change the way that you're going to be doing your battles. And you're going to have to adapt your strategy to these certain classes to really bring down the enemy, and you're going to have to adapt your strategy. So that's pretty much it on these classes. So C1, your newer models, your finest rifles. C2 is going to be your older models, your shorter barreled, like your shotguns and pistols, and they're not going to hit far out range. Your C3 is the outdated ones. You're going to have to get much closer to the enemy and able to do some damage. So that's pretty much the spiel on that. I just wanted to kind of share that with you all because I thought that was pretty cool. And it totally just changes the way you're going to be playing this game now. And so that's pretty much it. That was pretty awesome there. So when I do a campaign for you guys here on YouTube, we're going to have to really pay attention to what class they are and how we're going to use them. So anyway, let's kind of we have our generals over here. It's time, guys. Now, before I say anything, I'm starting to get teary-eyed here because when I originally installed this mod and had a go on it, as you know, in the previous versions, that these generals, most of them had the faces, but Lee's face wasn't even in there on the unit cards. So as you can see, his face is in there. Now, here's the thing. Here's what I was kind of wanting. And I've been wanting to have something like this in the mod for so long because I was always wondering, you know, it'd be cool if they actually had their faces in the units themselves. And so I just wanted to show you. It's time, guys. I just wanted to show you right there. There he is. Now, this took my breath away. Really, I was so happy to see this. Look at that. Just look at that. Wow, there he is. And wow, I'm speechless. I'm speechless. I've been wanting this for so long, and there it is. We have it. So this is what this patch is going to be adding, guys. It's going to be adding the real generals themselves. Gives a more realistic feel. So I hope that you're happy about that. I know I am. So Trick Buddy, you got me right there. You got me. This alone over exceeds my expectations about this mod. And, you know, just made me, when I first saw that, it made me just forget all my problems that I've been going through. And it just took my breath away. I didn't know what to think. I was speechless. I was getting teary-eyed. I'm kind of am now just talking about this, but there it is. So that is Lee for you guys. That's it. So we'll put him up to the front. Next up, we'll have George E. Pickett. Now let's see if he's in here. There he is. Pickett, up close and personal. There he is. Wow, guys, this is so cool. Pickett. Oh, man. Okay. Let's go on down. Jackson. Oh, this is going to be the killer one. Jackson. We got Jackson here. Let's see what we got. He looks so beautiful. Wow. There he is. I just got the flashback of Gods and Generals right now, guys. Of him standing with his arm up, with his hand up, bullet in the hand. And when you charge, yell with fury. Wow. Look at that, guys. That is beautiful. Absolutely great. Wow. That's what it's all about, guys. That is what this mod will add. So, next up, we'll have Jeb Stewart. James E.B. Stewart. Let's see what he has over here. There he is. That's him. Oh, wow. That is so cool. We have Jeb Stewart. Up close and personal. We did Lee. We did Pickett, we did Jackson, we have Johnston here. Joseph E. Johnston. Let's look at him. Let's give a good look at him and see what we got here. There he is. Wow. And you can see these are their faces. This is them. This is really them. Wow, that is absolutely a piece of work. Absolutely a piece of work. So we'll put you to the side. We have Mosby. Good old Mosby. Where are you at? There you are. Let's get you in there. There he is. Mosby. John S. Mosby. Ladies and gentlemen. Right there. Here we go. Next up, Beauregard. Pierre G.T. Beauregard. He will be right there. Oh, wow. That's it, guys. That is it. Oh, just... Whew. I don't believe this. Actually, Lee did it for me. Lee did it for me, really. I'm serious. We got James Longstreet here. There he is. James. Oh, the cigar! He's got the cigar! Hell yeah! Well done, Trig. That, wow. That is so awesome. Oh, man. He's got the cigar. Wow, wow, wow. Next up, Nathan Forrest. Let's see what you got here. We're going to switch over to the Union here pretty soon, and we're going to see all the generals there. There's Longstreet, or there's Nathan B. Forrest right there. Nathan B. Forrest. Hello. Guys, if this doesn't really get to you, and, you know, because I'm really passionate about this mod, but if this doesn't do it for you, well, I don't know what will. There's Patrick R. Claiborne. Right there he is. I couldn't get over Longstreet's cigar. That was so cool. And here we go, Braxton Bragg. Here we go. Let's see where he's at. He's right there. There he is, Braxton Bragg. How cool. How cool. Last but not least, we have John B. Hood. That would be him right there. John B. Hood. Hello. How are you? That is so cool, guys. So this is going to be the generals that are going to be in play in this mod, as well as showing you these different classes. So we're going to switch over to the Union, and we're going to see those generals. And here we are, guys. We are on the Confederate, and actually, for some reason, the sound is just... It's still not really... I fixed it, but it's weird like that, so... Let's go back to our battle here. We'll do that same one. We're going to do Eastern Theater to give you all a sense of what the units will be available for the Union. So let's go there. Now here's what we, let's see, we'll look at Sherman. Oh, I love to see Sherman's face. We got Sheridan, we got Burnside. I'm looking forward for Burnside. Chamberlain, we got Meade, Buford, Custer, Grant, Hancock, McDowell, McClellan, not cavalry. I think that's it. We can actually look at the 1st U.S. Cavalry there. I want to look at, now there, here's some other units in the Eastern Theater. Ooh, New Hampshire Volunteers. I want to see those. Let's see. What do we got here? Turner Rifles. The 20th New York United Turner Rifles Regiment. Wow. Okay, we got this. I think we looked at the 2nd Scotch in the last part. Connecticut Infantry. We got the New York Infantry. Let's see what else we got here. Something very, very cool. The Fighting Ninth. Oh, yeah, 9th Massachusetts. Let's look at those. 69th Pennsylvania Infantry, Union Engineers. That might be a good thing to look at. Union Marines, German Rangers. Oh, wow, I like to look at those later. Irish Brigade, that looks cool. 20th Maine Infantry, Iron Brigade, we're doing that one. Oh man, I've run out of money. You know what, let's not look at the New Hampshire Volunteers. Let's look at, Now you know what, screw the cavalry, I don't want to look at them right now. I want to look at some good old infantry. Let's find it, I think I've done the Irish, have I done the Irish? No, Union Irish Brigade, we'll look at those. There we go, and you know what, we'll look at some Union Cav, can we? You know what? Fine, that'll be good. That'll be good. And so we look at these, and just some for randomness, we'll just get some units there so we can look at it, and we'll see on the battle map. And here we are. It is raining, the meanest you ever saw, right now on this mod. Anyway, let's get you all grouped together. We'll send you all right here. Might want to just separate you a little bit. There we go. We'll just separate them. And also, I'm still gonna do the same thing about looking at these classes on the Union. And also, I want to see these units as well, because these are these are not in the Western Theater. This is the Eastern Theater, and I really want to see that. So anyway, we can look at the Union, the regular Cav here. They have the C2, as you can see, and they do mount. So we can look at the mounting. You can see that right there. They can dismount. They will mount, and they got the C2. They don't have. I don't see ranges there. They're probably just melee. They use the Sharps carbine. They'll probably fire as they charge. Yeah, there they are. There's that rifle there. They have the Sharps carbine. That's cool. Awesome. 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 Let's put them to the side. Here we go. What we have? Turner rifles. These are the ones I have not seen yet. They're using the Mississippi 1841. They are the C2. So that means that you're going to want to get to about right here in this range, or maybe about right there, for them to actually do any damage. So if they're out here, they're going to hit a little bit, but not as much as you're probably going to want them to. So Union has some of those lower classes as well. It's not just limited to the Confederates. It's with everybody. We have the 9th Connecticut Infantry. They're using the Springfield 1855. So as you can see, C2, it's an older model. And you're going to want to have them also about right there. All your C2s are probably going to be about right here for them. And they got a nice range. So you're going to want them about right here to really do any damage. And so this is what I said you're going to have to adapt your strategy to. So the New York Volunteers, 16th New York Infantry. Oh, look at those hats. Look at those hats. They got the Enfield P-1853, but they're a C1. So it's obviously a pretty damn good rifle. If it's a C1, that is so cool. So really, the yellow is at the very tip here. They're going to hit, but not as much. They'll do okay back here, but you're going to really want them about right there to really do any damage. Even this is the C1, so this is the difference in these rifles and how they present the ranges that you're going to have to really pay attention to. But look, those hats look freaking awesome. Look at that. Those are so cool. Oh, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. So let's look at here real quick. Let's look at the 9th Massachusetts, the Fighting 9th. We're using the Springfield 1842, so this is a C3 on this. So you're really going to have them right there to really do any damage. The yellow out here will do some damage. Red, you're not probably going to do much. And actually, if you pit it against a Confederate with a C1, that C1 is probably going to really tear them apart. So it's not a good idea to do that. So this is what I said. You're going to have to adapt your strategy. But they look rather awesome as well. Look at this. Oh, the buckle. That's so cool. Let's see what else we got here. Is there anything else on them that I'm missing? I don't think so. I like the little, what is that? The 9 on the hats. Oh, that's so cool. The Fighting 9th. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. We got the Union Engineers here, kind of like the Confederate Engineers. They are the C1 using the Springfield M1861, so, you know, out here it's going to be good. But, always the closer the better. So let's look at these guys, see what they're about. Oh, they got it on the hats. Oh, that's so cool. They got the little buckle. We can see the buckle also down here. And their rifles, that is awesome. That is awesome. Iron Brigade. I think a lot of people has been wanting to see this. The Iron Brigade. Let's look at them. They have the Lorenz rifle. They are a C2. So you're really probably going to have them. You're probably going to have the enemy right around here to do any damage. Out here, it'll be okay, but it'll take some time. And if you're going against a C1, they're going to thin your ranks before you even do anything. So you're going to, the closer the better on these guys. Yeah, that looks cool. The Iron Brigade. That is nice. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, so last but not least with the Irish Brigade. Remember that movie from Gods and Generals where they're in Fredericksburg and you got the Irish Brigade and the Confederate and the Irish Brigade and the Union, and they go, what are they doing? They know we're fighting for independence. They got the They got the, oh, that's so, they got it on the hats. That's so cool. They got the, little horn there. That is nice. I love it. I love it. I love it. And they will be using the Springfield 1842. So they are a C3. So not really. You want the enemy right around this blue line right there for them to really do anything. If you have them way out, they have a long range, but if you have them out here, they're not. It's not going to do a lot of damage. So with this, the closer the better, because these are the outdated ones, because the Springfield 1842. So that's what your C classes are all about, guys. That's pretty much the spiel on that, and it really, you're going to have to adapt your strategy with what classes are pitted up against which, and how you're going to use each class effectively. So brings in a whole different dynamic on this game. Okay, now guys, I'm sorry I'm running out of time. I want to show you these generals. I wanted to do a kind of a units in action and do some sieges, but guys, that's going to have to be postponed until the next video, because I'm already up to 25 minutes. But don't worry, guys, we will have the next video, and it will show, we're going to show some sieges, we're going to show some units in action. So stay tuned for that, guys, in the next video. And now we will look at George B. McClellan, and you can see the unit card right here. He is a C3, so really you're not going to want him in battle anyway. You're going to want him in the back, but you know, just in case, you know, all hell breaks loose and you're going to have to use a general, you're going to want to be up close and personal right around here for them to really do any damage. And also with charging as well, they do have the wedge formation. But there's really only 10 of them, so this is mostly for morale purposes, so that's what I would think. But yeah, that is so cool, so cool. So now we have that, we'll put you to the side. Irwin McDowell. I can't read it, I don't have my glasses. Irwin McDowell. Oh yes, right there he is. Right there he is. And I think all of these generals are a C3. Yes, all of these generals are a C3. So that's, you know, they got the outdated stuff, but you know, generals, you're not really going to want to really do anything with them anyway, except have them in the back for morale purposes. So yeah, there he is, Irwin McDowell. Yeah, so cool. So I see the thing on his hat there. Let's look at that U.S. You can see that right there. That is nice. And you can see he's a two-star. He's a two-star. Two-star general right there. That is cool. Oh, I'm speechless, guys. Speechless. This is absolutely magnificent. Absolutely. Now we have Winfield Hancock, and he will be right there. Hancock, I believe that's him. He doesn't have a hat, but that is his little beard right there. That's him. He's also, looks like he's two-star. That is cool. Well done, Trig. You've done it for me already. We haven't even done battles yet. You have already done it for me. And here we go. We got Ulysses S. Grant. Right there he is. Right there he is. He's got a lot of little hair right there. That is so cool. He's getting a little gray. Ah, yes. You can see he's a three-star. You can see the star right there on their shoulders. Right there. That is nice. Very nice indeed. You got his belt buckle. Okay. Awesome, awesome. His sword. Oh, nice. That is, man, I am just, wow. Wow, wow. Custer. Let's look at old Custer, shall we? George A. Custer. There you are. I think it's a two-star. Yes, that is a two-star. You got it on his hat as well. So, awesome. Pure awesomeness. I am. Wow. Okay, so next, John Buford. And he will be over here. That's him. Let's get a nice little zoom in. Let me see if I can get the camera properly. Right there. There he is. John Buford, ladies and gentlemen. And he'll be the one star. So, nicely done there. Here we go. Next up, George G. Meade. George G. Meade. What we got? Here he is, right there. Oh, wow. Man, the representation on this is just phenomenal. Phenomenal. So when you play your battles, and say if you have Grant or Lee in there, gives it a more real sense because they're actually right there. That's his face. He's right there. And this adds so much more realism to it. And with the dynamics with these classes, guys, it's, I mean, it just it just adds to the identity of this mod, the true identity. And you can see right there we have Chamberlain, Joshua Chamberlain. There he is. Got the U.S. hat on there. He's got his two star. Yeah, there's the two star. You got his other bodyguard here, and you can see. Let's see. Let's kind of look at it here, because I'm kind of curious myself. Let's see what we got there. You got the eagle on their sides of the bodyguard, and the general will have the stars. Will have the stars on his shoulder right there. So that's pretty much that. Okay. So next up we'll have Burnside. Oh, I'm looking forward to this, guys. I am looking forward to Burnside. Let's see him right there. Oh, there he is. He's got the Burnside going. He's got the sideburns connected with the mustache. That's it. That is it. That is it. Wow. Wow. Two star. Nice little hat there. Let's see. Is there anything? That's about it. I still can't get over two things. I can't get over Lee and Longstreet's cigar. That's done it for me right there, guys. That has done it for me. So anyway, here we go. We got Philip H. Sheridan. There he is. Nicely done. Nicely done. He's got a little. Looks like he's a little grumpy. It's so awesome. And last but not least, William Tecumseh Sherman. This is the guy who burnt Atlanta to the ground, ladies and gentlemen. And he is right there. And he's a three star. There he is, Sherman. All of them has the hats. You can see them, their faces here without their hats on the unit cards. Wow, guys. Well, unfortunately, I was wanting to show you all a siege and kind of show you some units in action. I've went 32 minutes, so I gotta quit here. Don't worry, guys. The next video we're gonna go really all balls out on this one. I'm gonna show you some sieges, show you some units in action, and the forts are actually gonna be a lot different in this game. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I hope that you join me for that. And guys, thank you so much for watching this. I do hope that you've enjoyed part two of our sneak peek of ACW 3.6 patch coming out soon. Thank you to Trig giving me the dev version, and let's congratulate Trig on this. He has done a magnificent job with these generals, and adding in the classes here of these guns really changes the gameplay. So, guys, next time we will look at the battles, we will look at the sieges. Now, in the next part, guys, I told you all that I was going to have about 3 to 5 videos put out on this. So, and also, this is the Eastern Theater. And probably next part, when we do these battles, I want to try to do a mix between your Western Theater and the Eastern Theater, kind of show you the diversity of troops in each. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. I do hope that you've enjoyed. Please remember to comment, thumbs up, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Google+, join my Steam group, and I'll have the links for you guys for you can go into the Total War Center forum on this mod, as well as the Mod DB site. So guys, we will see you all in part 3 of this sneak peek. Thank you so much for watching. We will see you next time.